checking in. Today is a Talia Joy tribute tutorial based on her saying "Just Keep Swimming" that she got from Finding Nemo, Miss Dory herself. And she was a big fan of Ellen and a big fan of the movie and a big fan of Ellen's character and how optimistic she was and how much she was how much of a fighter she was. I have a soft spot for Talia, or just for anyone who is battling cancer. I had my own experience with battling cancer. I battled it for a year, and just this past January is when I started to get my life back together again. When she passed this week, it really took a toll on me because she was the person I found inspiration with. When I found out that I had cancer, I was very down in the dumps, and watching Talia and how young she was and how long she fought for it, I said, you know, God bless me, because that could have been my situation. And for her to be having a harder situation than me and fighting and having a smile on her face, God bless her. And she made me push, and her little saying "just keep swimming" just made me kept going and kept fighting, and to have a smile on my face even on my hardest days. So I wanted this to be a tribute to her. Last year, when I was still battling cancer, I made a video thanking Talia for getting me up on my feet and to stay strong. She probably never saw it, and because of the turn of events, she probably never will. But she's an angel now. She has her set of wings, so she knows how I feel about her and how much she helped me get through life battling such a horrible disease. So thank you so much, Talia. Thank you so much. So this look is inspired by her inspiration, "Just Keep Swimming." And I kind of did like a sea inspired blue, deep blue sea kind of a look. And I just wanted to put a pop of color with my lips just to make it more fun, because Talia was all about being fun and being inspirational and upbeat. And I wanted this look to represent that. So here, guys, if you guys want to know how to do this tutorial inspired by Miss Talia Joy, the magnificent Talia Joy, please keep watching.
So as usual, you want to start off with the base. I'm using Soft Ochre Paint Pot by MAC, and this is just going to help our eyeshadow stick. Then I'm going to be applying NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk, and I'm going to blend it out up to my crease. This is going to help our colors to appear more vibrant. For a brow bone highlight, use something that's at least 2 to 3 shades lighter than your complexion, and make sure to match shade, and apply it onto your brow bone and blend it down. This is going to help with blendability when we get to our crease color. To highlight our inner corner, I'm going to be using MAC Vex, which is a duochrome shadow that has hints of purple and silver. And I'm going to blend this into my inner corner and take it up slightly into my crease. Taking MAC Atlantic Blue, I'm going to start packing this color on, blending it with Vex. Then I'm going to be taking MAC Tilt onto the center of my lid and blending Atlantic Blue and Tilt together. By flipping your brush back and forth, if you're using the same brush for both colors, this is going to help blend the two colors together so there isn't any harsh lines. Then I'm going to be taking Pearl Glide Intense Eyeliner by MAC and Patchouli Blue and shaping my crease and my outer V. Then I'm going to blend it onto the outer corner. Then I'm going to set it with Deep Truth Eyeshadow, which is a very intense navy blue shimmer shade. Then I'm going to be taking Contrast to deepen it out. Small blending brush such as the MAC 217, I'm going to start blending my color up into my crease and up towards the brow bone. This is going to help fade the color, so the most intensity would be on the lid and it fades up towards the crease and brow bone. Blending the
Then you want to take a fluffier blending brush, such as the MAC 224. And I'm taking a brown shade. You can take any brown shade that's suitable for your skin tone. But I will be using MAC Espresso and Swiss Chocolate. And this is going to help blend my crease color even more. Now take a black eyeshadow. I'm using Urban Decay's Blackout. And start shaping your crease and your outer V. Since we applied it with a pencil brush, now I want to take a blending brush to blend it out. Now clean up the edges with some makeup remover and a Q-tip to making sure it's sharp and clean. Now I'm going to be lining my top lash line with a gel eyeliner and winging it out at the end. With a black pencil liner, tight line and apply some onto your lower waterline. Taking my Soft Ochre Paint Pop base, I'm going to line my lower lash line. Then I'm going to apply the same colors that I apply on my lid. I'm going to apply this onto my lower lash line, starting with Vex, ending with Blackout. The time now to clean up and apply some mascara and some fluttery lashes. So this is Riri Boy with this eye look. And the other option is MAC Lovelorn, which is just a nice glossy look. And I'm going to top it off with MAC Hug Me. And that is option number two. For a contour and highlight, I use MAC Bronzer and Matte Bronze and MAC Flatter Me Pearl Mask Face Powder. And for cheeks, I mix Elamasca's Tweak and MAC Dolly Mix. And that is it. That is the Talia Joy tutorial. Just keep swimming. God bless her family. I hope they stay strong and I hope they stay with positive thoughts. And Natalia, God bless you. You were an angel. Thank you guys for watching and have a lovely, lovely day. Bye guys.